Hello learners, I am Dr. Rajendra Kumar Nayak from NIOS. At first I welcome all of you to our program. And last class we have discussed about set, that is how a set is formed, and representation of sets and classification of sets. And today we are going to discuss about other part of the set like subset. So today with us Dr. Rajpal Singh, PGT Mathematics. I welcome to our program, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And at first, sir, you tell me what is set and how it is different from subset.
We are going to introduce about subsets. As this word sub is used before any other word, it gives us a meaning of a part of. So when we say a subset, it gives us a meaning that it is part of a set. So first, we are getting a meaning that subset is a part of set. Now we should understand exactly by taking an example that what do we mean by a subset. Let us understand it through this example. Here, as we see, set A is represented as X such that X is a student of the school, means this set contains all students of the school, and set B, this is represented as X such that X is a student of class 11th of the school. So it clearly gives us a meaning that students of class 11th are part of the whole strength of the students of school. So we can say that set B is a subset of A, as we see that collection B is a part of the collection A, means student of class 11th are a part of students of all school. Here in this example, on left column we have got some sets and on right side we have got subsets of this set. First set is empty set phi, and when we make part of this set phi, it is the only one because it doesn't contain anything. Next set is 1, and here one of the part is set itself of its part, and when we don't take anything of that set, then it becomes empty set. Another set we have taken 1, 2, and when we make subsets of this set, we get as one subset as 1, second subset having element 2, third subset having element as 1, 2, and fourth subset as element 5, again empty set. And likewise, we make subsets of the set which is containing elements 1, 2, 3, they are 1, then 2, 3, then a subset is there having 1, 2, another subset is having 2, 3, 3, 1, and at last as a whole it is 1, 2, 3 and 5.
So let me clarify how a subset is different from a set.
See, subset is different from a set, but in one case it is not different from a set, because when we say that subset is a part of set, then we take some elements of that set and we make it a set, and it is formed as a subset. So when we don't take any element from the set, then also it is a subset and we represent it by empty set. But when we take whole of the set, then it is also defined as a part of that set, and in that case set becomes a subset of itself.
Yes, sir. One of the question is how we come to know that the subsets are left from the set.
See, we can check out whether all the subsets of the set have been formed or some subset is left. It will be better to understand it through an example. Here in this slide, the very first set we have taken, that was empty set, and we know the number of elements in empty set, that is 0, and we have formed the subset, the total number of subsets formed was 1. Then in second set, there was only one element, 1, and here the total subsets formed were 1 and 5 as 2. The second set we have taken in the previous slide, that was having 2 elements, and we were having four subsets as 1, 2, 1, 2 and 5. So, total number of subsets were 4. Likewise, the third set, it was having 3 elements 1, 2 and 3, and the subsets we have formed that were 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 5 and set itself, in totality 8 subsets were formed. If we relate these two figures, when number of elements in set are 0, then 1 can be represented as 2 raised to power 0, as we can see in the slide. Then if number of elements in set are 1, then subsets were 2 and it can be written as 2 raised to power 1. If number of elements in set are 2, subsets were 4, which can be represented as 2 raised to power 2. If number of elements in set were 3, then total subsets formed were 8, which can be represented as 2 raised to power 3. So, we can make a relation here: 0, 2 raised to power 0, 1, 2 raised to power 1, 2, 2 raised to power 2, 3, 2 raised to power 3. So, we can derive a conclusion here: if number of elements in set are n, then total number of subsets will be 2 raised to power n. Means if I am having a set as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, means total number of elements in the set are 5, then total number of subsets without forming subsets, I can find out it is 2 raised to power 5, means 32. So, in totality there will be 32 subsets of the set having 5 elements.
Sir, you want to talk that if you know the number of elements, then we easily find out the number of subsets.
Exactly. 2 raised to power n is the number of subsets, and when n elements are there, 2 raised to power n subsets are there, we can put down any value for n and we can find out the total number of subsets of a set.
Sir, what is the use of these subsets? Why we learn these subsets in set theory?
See, in logical mathematics, when we don't know exactly about the two sets, then to proving the equality of sets, subset is the most important tool, and to prove that two sets are equal, we use to prove that A and B, if they are two sets, then A will be equal to B if A is a subset of B and B is a subset of A. Means two sets are said to be equal if they are subset of each other.
Yes.
This is the way the logical mathematics equality of sets is proved. And now question arises, how to prove that one subset is a subset of another subset?
Yes.
In that case, we prove it in the way that if there is an element x which belongs to A, if x belongs to A implies x belongs to B, then we say that A is a subset of B. Here is the symbol which represent that is subset of. In subsets, you have seen that there were two types of sets. We have said that in subsets, in formation of subsets, you have seen that there are two types of subsets: one, set itself, an empty set, and another type of subsets were different type of subsets which are formed. So, on the basis of these two characters, we categorize subset in two parts. One is called improper subsets, which includes phi and set itself, and proper subsets other than phi and set itself, whatever the subsets are formed, they are called proper subsets. So, in this way, if we have to find out the number of proper subsets, then it will be equal to 2 raised to power n minus 2, because we know that in all the cases there are at least two subsets of a set and they are called improper subsets. When they are subtracted from the total number of subsets, we get number of proper subsets. There is only one exception: when at least two subsets are not there, that is in case of empty set phi, because in that case empty set and set itself, they become same. So, when they are equal, the number of subsets formed, that is only 1. Otherwise, in all the cases of all type of sets, there are at least two subsets of H sets which are improper, empty set and set itself.
So, you want to talk that a set has at least minimum two number of subsets.
Exactly. Exception is only 5. In that case, yes, only one subset is there. And on the basis of subsets, a new type of set is defined in set theory, and that is called power set of A. And this set is defined as, it is formed with the help of subsets of a set. Here we can see PA is the symbol for power set, and it is formed of set of all subsets of a given set. Yeah. If you want to define it, we want to represent it, that is PA equal to X, and element X is defined that it is a subset of A. Means, for example, there is a set with us as having elements 1, 2, then power set of A will be set containing element 1, set containing element 2, then 1, 2 and empty set, and then they are enclosed in a bracket when they are represented in the form of set. This particular set is called power set of the set A. Now we come to know one more type of set, which is called universal set. Universal set is a set which contains every object of that particular type. Means, if I say the universal set of books, it means it contains every type of book. It may be of nursery class, it may be for engineering, medical, means any type of book. If it is a book, it will be in universal set of book. If I say universal set of furniture, it may be any type of furniture, may be wooden, iron, any type of furniture. This will be universal set of furniture. The only condition, it should be a furniture.
Why it is called universal set? What any linking with the word universe?
It's named after the word, or it say its meaning is taken from the word universe. As we know, universe is the term which is used to describe that which contains everything. Universal set also a set which contains every element, but in one thing it is differed. It contains everything of that particular type of things. Means, as we have given an example of books, so universal set means it will be restricted only up to the elements as books.
Yes.
If it is books, universally, if any type of book is there, that will be in that collection and that will be universal set. But there are some clarification. We can see universal set does not mean a set that contains all elements of universe. All elements of universe means, it means everything is there in set. Secondly, universal set for one problem may not be universal set for another problem. Means, universal set of books and universal set of furniture, these two will be different universal set. Universal set for books cannot be universal set for furniture. So, they are different in, because they are restricted up to that particular type of objects.
Yes, sir. One question is, in the context of number theory, how sets are related to each other?
Let us understand it. The very first set in number system we have studied, that was set of natural numbers, from where origin of numbers is started. Then after numbers, the set extended and it became set of whole numbers.
Yes.
So, after inclusion of 0, set of natural number became set of whole numbers, and at the same time we can also understand that set of natural number is a subset to the set of whole numbers. After that, when integers were added to this collection, it became set of integers, and we can understand that natural numbers and whole numbers, they both became subset of integers. And after that, when rational and irrational numbers were included in this collection, whole of these three sets, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, we can understand that they became a subset to set of rational and irrational numbers. And we know that collection of all these type of numbers, we define it as real numbers. So, they all, including rational, irrational, integers, whole number, natural numbers, all these sets are subsets of real numbers. And one more type of number when we discovered iota, we found that real numbers are also a part of complex number when its imaginary part is 0, real numbers became a subset to the set of complex number. So, as a whole, complex number became the largest set, and in particular context of numbers, we can say that set of complex number is a universal set in context of numbers.
So, can you represent this number in a graphical form or in a pictorial form?
Yes, we can see in this slide, which is started from complex numbers, which is the largest set. Then from when imaginary numbers are excluded, it is confined up to real numbers. Then real numbers are divided into two parts, rational and irrational. Then after excluding fraction part, it turns out to be in integers. Then after excluding negative numbers, it goes to whole numbers, and after excluding zero, it becomes natural numbers. A mathematician, John Wayne, tried to visualize all these type of concepts which we are talking about till now, and let us understand through this example. Here in this picture, in a rectangle, a corner it is written as U, which represents a universal set, and here there are three different circles A, B and C. Can we draw any conclusion on the basis of this diagram?
Yes, sir. I have seen that B is here, B is a subset of A, and there is no relation between A, C and B and C, and both A, B, C all are comes under U.
Exactly. See, this is the power of visualization of this concept, that we do not know what are the elements of A, what are the elements of B, what are the elements of C. But without knowing any element, we can draw the conclusion that B is a subset of A, because B is totally contained in A. And as C is representing entirely in a different circle, so there is no common element in the collection of A and C, or say B and C. So we try to represent sets through Venn diagram also, and it gives us some very clear meaning when on the basis of definition we are not able to draw some conclusion. Now we will understand some different type of operations on a set, and the very first we come across, that is difference of two sets. Let us taking it through an example. Set A is taken as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Set B is taken as 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Now difference of A and B means A minus B, that is equal to represented as a set having elements 1, 3 and 5. The operation which is performed that we do is the elements which are common in both A and B, they are excluded from the set A when B is subtracted from A. So, elements common were 2, 4 and 6. So, after exclusion of 2, 4 and 6 in set A, we have the elements as 1, 3, 5. At the same time, if we subtract A from B, then we will exclude 2, 4 and 6 from set B, and we get the element as 8, 10. Here we can see that A minus B and B minus A, we are getting two different sets, so they are not equal. This is also visible from this Venn diagram. When A minus B is represented with a set which is shown as blue colored, and B minus A is represented by a part which is represented by an orange color. A minus B is represented when a green part which is common in both A and B, that is excluded from A, and that is A minus B. Mathematically, it is written as if any element X belongs to B minus A, then it implies that X belongs to A, but X does not belong to A. And using this operation of difference, or say subtraction, we define one more type of property of a set, which is called complement of a set, and it is defined using the set, universal set. Complement of a set is fine as the set A we have taken that x is a natural number, then another set B is there that x is not a natural number. First of all, we should see the symbol. Complement of A is represented by A dash, or say A, where a small c is written on the top of A, and that we find as U minus A, means all elements of A are excluded from the universal set of that particular type, or say universal set to that set A. So, universal set we define as X such that X belongs to U, but X does not belong to A. It will be very good and visible through this example in Venn diagram. A set A is represented with this color white, and except A, whole of the rectangle that is represented by A dash. So, we come to the meaning that all elements which does not belong to A, that elements belongs to A dash, or say complement of A. And at the same time, I want to find out again complement of this A dash also. It means I have to find out it will be A, because all shaded area with colored blue that is excluded from U, again we will get set A. So, complement of a set, again we get the same set.
So, A and A dash are disjoint sets.
Exactly, because as in definition we have said, which does not belong to A, that belong to the complement of that set. So nothing is common between the two.
So, if you together A and A complement, so it become a universal set, sir.
Certainly, if A and A dash, they are combined, then we say, or say we find universal set of that particular type.
Thank you, sir. Today we have discussed about complements of sets, power set and Venn diagrams, and next class we will be discuss about different operation of set theory. So, once again thank you, sir.
ये है कूल लाइफ, नो फिकर, नो टेंशन। एक हम है कंगले।
पर यार एक्सीडेंट हो गया तो?
तू भी जनानियों की तरह उधेड़बुन में लगा रहता है। जिंदगी एक ही बार मिलती है, एंजॉय। अब कहाँ चल दिया?
मेरी इकोनॉमिक्स की क्लास है।
अबे तेरे बिना वहां क्या कमी रह जाएगी?
मैं ये चैप्टर नहीं समझ पाऊंगा।
जा
बाय।
और बगला भगत, यार तू तो रहेगा हमेशा कुएं का मेढक, लेकिन भैया हम तो दुनिया में फुल लैश करेंगे।
यार तू समझता क्यों नहीं? यार
क्या अक्ल मुझे भी है, मुझे पता है कि हमें नौकरियां करनी होंगी। आज तक जिंदगी पढ़ते पढ़ते गुजर गई, 2 साल बाद सर पे नौकरी की तलवार टंगी होगी और हम कौन सा लाट कलेक्टर बन जाएंगे? बस गुजारे लायक तनख्वाह होगी। इस दुनिया में इतनी मौज है, मस्ती है, ऐश है, उसमें हमारा हिस्सा कहाँ है? क्या
ले बेटा खा।
चाची जी आप सुबह से रात तक काम करती हैं, थक नहीं जाती?
हाँ थक तो जाती हूँ बेटा, पर क्या करूँ, अब तो सुरिंदर की बहू ही आकर के आराम देगी।
बहू क्या ऐसे ही आ जाती है? खर्चा करना पड़ता है, बहुओं को कुछ देना भी पड़ता है।
अरे मेरी बहू आए तो सही, मैं उसे सोने की चूड़ियां पहनाऊंगी, सोने की। हाँ अरे अब मोबाइल क्या देख रहा है? तुझे क्या मालूम, मैंने एक एक पैसा जोड़ जोड़ कर अपनी बहू के लिए सोने की चूड़ियां बनवाई है। मनीष बेटा, ये तेरा दोस्त है, इस तरह इसका ध्यान रख। स्कूल तो इसने तेरे साथ पार कर ही लिया है। ले ले सागौन ले ले।
नहीं नहीं।
क्यों? अरे ले भी ले।
अबे यार, वहां हमारे ग्रुप का क्रेडिट कार्ड चलता है।
क्रेडिट को हिंदी में कर्ज कहते हैं।
तुझे नहीं पता, मेरा ग्रुप बहुत दिलदार है। 100-100 के नोट तो वो कुछ समझते ही नहीं।
जिस दिन तुझे उन्हें दावत देनी पड़ेगी तब क्या करेगा? वो तुझे फ्री में देकर आदत बिगाड़ रहे हैं।
मर्द बच्चा हूं मैं तो, बस जरा मस्ती के लिए, आदत वादत में नहीं डालूंगा। जब चाहे यूं छोड़ दूंगा।
तो अभी छोड़ दे।
क्या हुआ?
मना कर गया।
मैं तो पहले ही कह रहा था, गोली मारो उसे। उसकी भेजे में बात नहीं आएगी, उसकी किस्मत में खुश रहना नहीं लिखा है।
चाची जी, सब्र कीजिए, सब ठीक हो जाएगा।
अरे कैसे सब्र करूं बेटे, कितनी मुश्किल से अकेली ने मैंने ये बेटा पाला है और ये बेटा मुझे ये रंग दिखा रहा है। अरे और मैं तो किसी से कह भी नहीं सकती। न जाने कैसे कैसे पैसे जुटा के मैंने इसकी बहू के लिए चूड़ियां बनवाई थी।
बहू के लिए बनवाई थी ना, बेटे ने ले ली तो क्या आफत आ गई?
अरे उल्लास पीटे, अरे तू चला जा, एक तो चोरी ऊपर से सीना चोरी।
मुझे अपने घर में बाहरी लोगों का दखल पसंद नहीं। आप जाओ।
अरे अरे सत्यानाशी, चुप हो जा। मनीष मनीष बेटे, तो इसकी बातों का बुरा मत मानना।
चाची जी,
बहुत बुरा किया तूने, तूने बहुत बुरा किया। डॉक्टर साहब, मेरे बच्चों को बचा लीजिए।
आप थोड़ा सब्र रखिए, चिंता ना करिए, हम अपनी तरफ से पूरी कोशिश करेंगे। सुरेंद्र, हम आपको 15 दिन के लिए इस सेंटर पर रखेंगे। दवाइयों एवं बातचीत द्वारा हम आपका इलाज करेंगे, पर एक बात का ध्यान रखना होगा, दवाइयों से इस आदत से छुटकारा नहीं मिल सकता। इसके लिए आपको अपना आत्मविश्वास बढ़ाना होगा, और अगर इस आदत को छोड़ने की तुम मन में ठान लो तो दुनिया की कोई ताकत आपको रोक नहीं सकती। इस बात को हमेशा ध्यान रखना।